Brothers and sisters, the second category. What have I prepared? If I have it, alhamdulillah, look after it. It is a gem, it is a diamond, and it is more than a diamond. Shabun nasha'a fi ibadatillahi ta'ala. A youngster, youth, in the bubbling and bursting energies that he has because of his youth and his age, his strength, he used all that in the obedience of Allah, not in the disobedience of Allah. So as he became a teenager and he grew into his 20s and 30s, he ensured that he read his salah, he abstained from sin, he did not use his ears to hear that which was dirty, which displeased Allah. He did not use his eyes to look in the direction of the displeasure of Allah. If that is the case, male or female, Allah says, that person will be told, your presentation is so, so beautified in our eyes that we have made you a VIP on this day. Come forth to this VIP stand. Allahu Akbar. So let us ask Allah to grant us offspring who will be like that at least. And let us ask Allah to make us from amongst those. I'm sure a lot of us have tried to do that. Allah will accept the trial. May Allah forgive our shortcomings. We are but human beings. Allahu Akbar. So my brothers and sisters, those who are young, the youth, remember, if you want to be a VIP the day you pass away, the day of judgment, you need to nurture, bring yourself up in the obedience of Allah. Do not let things distract you from your goal. I know of top sportsmen, and I have to give the example of sports because a lot of us here would be following a ball, you know, we'd be following a ball more than we follow sometimes things which are even more important. But I think the youth would know what we are speaking about. I met some Muslim brothers who play with a certain team, and they met us and then they said, we need to get back because if we are not back by 10 o'clock at night, we will not be able to play tomorrow. The manager or the captain will not allow us. The coach, in fact, he does not allow. So they are very strict. They sleep on time, they get up on time. Why? Because they are fearful of not being in the team the following day. Don't we want to be in the team of the VIPs on the day of judgment? So sleep on time and get up on time. And be disciplined and don't eat this food and that food, subhanallah, if it is haram and if it is in the displeasure of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's be in the same team. Remember, the shade that Allah has prepared for that particular day, that particular shade is vast. There is no specific number of people that will be granted entry into that. It is open-ended. You know, a few days ago I walked into one restaurant here in KL and I read on the menu it says a bottomless Coke. And I thought, astaghfirullah, will I have to close my eyes when I see this bottomless Coke? Astaghfirullah. But when I asked what it means, they told me it means it's bottomless. I said, but that doesn't answer my question. Subhanallah. It means you drink and you keep on pouring. You drink, I said, okay, I understand. A bottomless Coke, meaning, you know, one side is open. Allahu Akbar. That is the word they have chosen to describe when they say you pay once and you drink as much as you can for as long as you're drinking here. So when we go there next time, we know to make ourselves very thirsty before we actually get there. Why is it that we are so crazy for a free Coca-Cola? We're so crazy. If someone said bottomless, yes, go for that one. Why is it we're so crazy for the... When you enter a restaurant and they tell you today is special, everyone says, what is it? I've witnessed it. Everyone is looking at today is special. You are going to gain 5 ringgit. That's maximum. Maximum you will gain. But we are so excited because 5 ringgit is a lot of money. My brothers and sisters, why don't we look at the discounts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He says, you want paradise? Well, here you are. These are some of the things you could do. Shabun nasha'a fi ibadatillahi ta'ala wa rajulun qalbuhu mu'allakum bil masajid. A man whose heart is stuck to the masjid. It is hanging in the masjid. Allahu Akbar. Which means he reads his salah. And when he goes out, he's worried about when is the next salah. And when he goes out again, he's worried about when is the next salah. Believe me, if you do that, it will keep you away from sin. Because you are worried. I have my wudu. After Asr, it's almost Maghrib. I will go to a place or two. I am worried about the masjid. Brothers and sisters, the brothers especially, the sisters, we invite you really to be concerned about your salah, although you know the narration states that it is better for a female to read at home. At the same time, the brothers, your heart, try and stick it into the masjid. You see, when we said youth who grow up as obedient people, some of us are already old. So we say, oh, I've lost it already. The train is gone. Because, you know, when I was young, I did this and did that. So there is another one. The other one is, you can stick your heart into the masjid. Allahu Akbar. No matter how old you are, even if you've done it towards the end of your life, the fact that your heart is stuck in the house of Allah, you think on the day of Qiyamah, Allah will not look at that as the big presentation? What is your presentation, brother? Ya Allah, I tried never to miss salah in your house. My heart was always there. So Allah says, you qualify for a VIP status here. Come. Allahu Akbar. The shade of the day of Qiyamah is granted to a man whose heart is stuck in the masjid. And I've explained, you go out, your heart is in there. You want to go back. You come in, you sit. You feel so hurt, so sore to have to walk out of the house of Allah. And this is why when we build the masajid, we need to build beautiful masajid just like this one, mashallah. It has beautiful sound. It has the beautiful air conditioning units. It has the fans. It has a high ceiling. It has great space. It has a good carpet like a mattress, mashallah. Who would want to feel like walking out of here? Allahu Akbar. May Allah make us from those who don't get irritated when we come into a masjid. Surprisingly, youngsters walk into nightclubs, they come out at 3 in the morning drunk and drugged. Do you know that? Witness it, I'm sure it may be happening somewhere around. It's a global problem. How many of us can be as crazy about the masajid? I know it's a very low example, but it's a reality. So we are pressing the button. Once a week, twice a week, thrice a week. They will go and club it and they will enjoy and they will behave like hooligans. And they will do that which is detrimental, not only for their deen and dunya, but their health as well. They are destroying it. And at the same time, they lose everything. But that is their dedication. How many of us can be as crazy? We are supposed to be even more crazy. When I say crazy, I'm not talking about it in the English language meaning sense. We are talking about it in what is understood in our language, which means we really would like it. That's what it means. You know, today I was sitting with one of the brothers and he told me something correct. Sometimes some people take you literally and then they don't understand what you've said. You have a literal speech, so you use a word. So I thought of it quickly. I said, brother, I said crazy. I don't mean mad, but I mean, you know, really fond of something to the degree that you would want to do it by hook or crook. Mind you, that also is terminology that needs to be understood. Hook or crook. Allahu Akbar. I don't know why the English language is such that they use bad words to describe good things, you know. Hook or crook means by any means. But they literally saying, you know, even if you steal for it, we are not inviting you to steal. Please, my brothers and sisters, you know that. So, the sisters as well, you read one salah, when are you going to read the next? It's in your heart. This is the same. You will have the same. It's in your heart. Let me prepare for the next one. So you come early. You know, with us, Jumu'ah Salah, we arrive late. We are rushing for it. Wallahi. To be honest with you, look at the masjid. Just sit in any masjid on the globe. You will find people, a large number of people, coming after the khutbah has already started. And that is the main prayer. I, in my country, have some churches around the masjid. And we look at them, they visit the church for 3-4 hours at a time. They come early. We go to the masjid, we leave the masjid, we are out. They were there before we went in and they are there after we left. But they are still dedicated. And they are standing and they are engaging in whatever they are engaging in. And I think to myself, wallahi, if we as Muslimin had to be half as dedicated as these, it's sad to give such low examples. But this is what will wake us up. If we had to be half as dedicated about haqq, then they are about batil, we would be solving the matter. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the shade of the day of Qiyamah. So that is the next category. Then there is a beautiful category. We've heard already the three. Imamun Adil. Shabun nasha'a fi ibadatillahi ta'ala. Rajulun qalbuhu mu'allakum bil masajid.